Well, this expedition, the Sverus C3, is a large program centered around this expedition. It's a Swedish, Russian, U.S. Arctic Ocean investigation, studying the couplings between the climate, the cryosphere, and the carbon cycle. So the cryosphere that we're focusing on here is very much the subsea and coastline permafrost, of which most of that is centered in the Isabian Arctic Ocean. But we're also very interested in the sea ice in the present system and historically. And we're interested in frozen methane, methane hydrates. We're particularly interested in the mechanism and fluxes that causes the release of this strong greenhouse gas. We want to increase the understanding of that system so that we can make predictions of how those fluxes will develop in the future.
Our two different legs are complementing each other pretty much, whereas you have the shallow areas, as Örjan described, over the Siberian shelf. We're going to go a little bit further out on leg two and look more at the gas hydrate system along the slopes. We're going to look more for records, long sedimentary records, where you can study the sea ice history, and also look at the whole export of carbon from the shallow areas out to the central Arctic Ocean, and trying to understand all these couplings. You need all the pieces. So that's why we designed this very multidisciplinary expedition, that you link all these pieces, and it's not enough to understand one part. You need to understand them all to lay the whole puzzle.
But this Odin-based Sverus expedition to the East Siberian Arctic Ocean is good news on many different levels. It's certainly very good news for moving forward our knowledge about the Arctic and the climate interactions in a key region, this East Siberian Arctic Ocean. And it's thanks to this collaboration between Sweden, Russia, US and several other countries. It's good news for the research. It's very good news for Stockholm University and for our Bolin Center for Climate Research and all the participating scientists. It gives us an opportunity to strengthen further an area where we already are reasonably strong. That is this Arctic carbon climate links and the whole Arctic system science in a sense. So the Sverus C3, I think, will have a legacy for years to come, where many students and researchers here, Stockholm University and our collaborators worldwide, will benefit from observations taken during this expedition and samples that we bring back and that we can investigate for many years to come.
Odin is a very good and capable icebreaker to begin with. And already when they designed Odin, they had research in mind. So they made all these placements for containers, etc. So it was thought of from the beginning. And what happened then is that the research community has equipped Odin with a lot of installations, like the multibeam echo sounder we have, etc. We have lab facilities. So we have, from underneath and up, from the community, we have constantly developed Odin, together with the owners, of course, and the Polar Secretariat. So Odin today is a very, very, very well-equipped research icebreaker. And if you compare to many other icebreakers, it's not only extremely good in the way it can go around the ice and come up into the central Arctic, it's also very, very nice to work on. It's a pleasant environment. It's one of the nicest ships I've ever been on. So you have all this nice environment with high-tech equipments on. That makes it a very pleasant workplace.